Hey everybody, this is JBizzo49.
And Prometheus MFD.
Why am I doing this?
I don't know, because I told you to. I bothered you about it.
You magnificent bastard.
I am not Rommel.
Unfortunately.
Yeah.
So, as you may have surmised from the title at the top, we are about to delve into the hallowed depths that is Metroid Other M.
I'm going into this blind.
Yeah, I kind of want to do this little intro thing before we hit play, just to kind of set, like... I know about this, but I'm going to ask you anyway, just so the folks at home know. What do you know about the Metroid franchise?
Alright. First of all, Samus is a girl. Shocker.
It was his sled.
Damn you, Citizen Kane and TV tropes.
Indeed.
But, one of the main enemies against Samus is Ridley, and people apparently like pairing them up a lot, which is weird, because he's a space dinosaur, and she's a human raised by bird statue people.
Which is weird in itself.
She goes around gathering items to upgrade her suit so that she doesn't die.
Mm-hmm.
They're space pirates, which are typical aliens. And there's an alliance of planets, or whatever it is. And that was totally my phone going off.
Don't worry about it. If the game's not gonna give a shit, we won't. before we hit play, what do you know about Other M that isn't from me?
I've maybe seen half a cutscene.
I think you watched, like, half of the first cutscene in Character Assassination Authorized, the thing that Retsupre did.
Yeah, but...
And then we gotta do this.
Yeah, I realized I have to do this blind, because there is no way it could be funnier if we both knew what we were getting into.
Instead, only one of us knows what the hell we're getting into.
You know, I've heard the things that it wasn't very well received, and... But I think that's a bit undercut by the fact that, one, I haven't seen it, and two, the only other knowledge I have of it is the Penny Arcade comic from when it was first announced, when everyone was like, oh my god, this is going to be the greatest Metroid game ever!
So and then any other knowledge you have is from me bitching about it constantly.
Which I hardly remember.
So you really are going into this thing blind.
Pretty much. I mean, I'm aware that they have Samus talking, and that's a bit too much, but...
if you think that it's a bit too much, you haven't seen the half of it yet.
Yeah, I see. I'm waiting to judge on whether or not that's true. I'm going into this with a neutral palette.
Which will totally be colored by, you know, what I think.
Hate. It's colored by hate.
Indeed. We'll tell you like where to send your hate beams.
Yeah.
When we get to the fucking stupid ass storyline.
Now I have the song "Black Wings of Hate" by Van Canto stuck in my head.
Oh, good god. Okay, but before you start singing, let's just start this thing in 3, 4, 2, 1, play.
Oh, goody.
You know a video is starting off well when the first thing you see in the video is the Wii menu itself.
Oh, had the YouTube video turned way too loud.
That's alright.
Oh, standard how to hold the Wii remote thing, because apparently we're 2 months old and can't remember that. I've got cousins who are second cousins who are like two years old and know how to hold a Wii controller between games.
Okay, go into options, and you can change the language of the subtitles in the game, and you can change the subtitles. Oddly enough, you cannot change the voice acting from English to Japanese, a feature I would have thoroughly enjoyed after hearing the fucking English voice acting.
Other M in French.
No, there's only two voice...
I know.
English and Japanese, but it's just, it could be subtitled here in North America in English, French, or Spanish.
because we got Mexico and Canada.
Indeed. And that's why pretty much, like, when you read an instruction manual North America, it's in those three languages.
These visuals aren't half bad.
Yeah, if I'm going to say one thing about this game that is positive, is that the CG is absolutely fantastic.
It's... Oh, God. Anyone else think of the Star Child ending of 2001 A Space Odyssey when they see this?
Oh, God.
I love that movie, but...
How does the baby have a full head of hair?
That can occasionally happen. Happened with me.
And hence why it's all, like, weird and shit now.
Why am I still alive?
I ask that question every single day when I wake up.
Okay, that's not the best first dialogue baby. To have with your previously silent character. Baby. Oh, I'm guessing this is bad. This is Super Metroid when the
yes,
baby Metroid.
Yes, this is recounting the events of Super Metroid. Though I don't remember most of this shit.
This actually looks pretty exciting. They got Mother Brain rendered pretty well there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you know, I'm digging this, except for the voice acting's a bit stilted. But I've only seen two lines. Maybe it'll get better.
Sorry to disappoint you.
Maybe it will get better. Oh shit, that's bad. That's pretty good.
No.
Did they ever establish whether or not Samus developed a maternal instinct with that baby Metroid?
You know, it's funny you should ask that.
I mean, outside this game?
I don't think so.
Because I know she's a very bare-bones character.
What's happened to music? Did somebody fucking put in Neon Genesis Evangelion by accident? I don't remember all this particle effect shit in Super Metroid. Oh, right! Forgot about you.
Her hand... The gauntlet on her hand...
Time to
was...
Go.
Seemed a bit too thin for human fingers.
Mother, time to go. Probably one of Samus's few well-delivered lines in this game.
That was neat. I like how they showed how the energy blasts are formed.
It's significant detail missing. You actually had to shoot Mother Brain 36 times in Super Metroid to kill it.
Separation of gameplay and cutscenes.
Oh. You're going to be saying that a lot. Got this Austin Powers reject over here.
I awoke to the familiar voice of a quarantine officer.
I got in trouble a lot.
Let's try sitting up, huh? Slowly
down. Oh, God. That...
A dream.
Oh.
I had been reliving the tragic moments
of
my recent past.
I have been reliving the tragic moments of my tragic past. Oh,
my
God, this is terrible.
Now you try.
Which was given to me somehow by the baby.
What the fuck?
I laid Mother Brain to waste.
It's like, oh my god.
And the explosion that followed destroyed...
We're not even 5 minutes in and I'm already like, wow, this voice acting is terrible.
The space pirates.
I mean, it's not even like Resident Evil terrible where it's fun.
Where it's so bad it's hilarious. Stop it. Don't open that door.
Come on, Samus. Let's go next door.
Let's go next door.
Herp Ed Derp. Is what I call that voice.
So she's in the Zero Suit for, I guess, fan service?
That's my only explanation.
Because that's clearly a slightly different Samus. They made her more attractive, air quotes.
You remember when the power suit actually formed via explosion? Apparently the people that made this game did.
You know, honestly, I gotta say, that's a pretty cool way to gain armor, by having it explode from a suit.
Ready for a quick test,
suit.
Samus?
Right, we have a little bit of a tutorial area where the game will introduce you to the controls. This is the first problem you will run into in this game. The fucking controls! Because you are limited to Wiimote only.
Oh, really? Not even the classic controller?
Not even the classic controller,
not even
Wiimote plus Nunchuck. Just the Wiimote.
Oh.
Okay.
Is it always in this 3D... thing?
Go ahead and drop some.
Most of the game is. And as you can imagine, moving around in a 3D environment, I've never liked doing that with the D-pad. I didn't like doing it in Super Mario 64 DS, and it was actually executed better in that game. Whee!
Huh. So have they...
Surprised? From there, kick climb. To
kick climb, as opposed to, you know, wall jumping, which they had a name for.
Just like that.
Indeed.
Samus.
But...
Let's invite some of your pals.
It's like they had... It's like an indie game, voice acting. Where it's that kind of casual voice acting, but...
You know, you know, the number of takes they took was somewhere between 0 and 2.
Let's check your reaction time.
They had decimals.
Here come some beams.
Decimal
right,
chaos.
Are you guys ready for some Matrix dodging?
Oh, that's... Hey, that looks like it could be... That could have been executed pretty fun if it was done right. You know, leaping around. That's something Samus really hasn't had, the leaping around ability.
I think you could attribute this to to Team Ninja and how they incorporated, you know, the 3D Ninja Gaiden engine into this game.
Well, honestly, I know Samus is supposed to be a walking tank, a la Super Soldiers.
Your pesky buddies is lurking here somewhere.
Okay, here's the second problem you're going to run into in this game. To change from third-person to first-person perspective, you have to point the Wii Remote at the TV screen, and you have to do this changing from the holding it sideways.
Which seemed like a good idea at the time.
Here's the third problem you're going to run into. Using missiles. You can try every button combination possible in third-person perspective. You could try, you know, getting the game disc ripped out and, like, snapping it in half, and you won't be able to use missiles from the third-person perspective. The only way to use missiles in this game is to switch to the first-person perspective, lock on to something that is missileable, like an enemy, and then you're able to shoot a missile.
Huh.
This gets annoying!
Can you still move in first-person?
You can move in basically spinning around in place. That's it!
That's bad.
That's just bad design.
That's like pre-GoldenEye bad.
Allow adequate room around you during powerbomb.
Right. That'd be the end of this little tutorial section here.
That's it for the test.
So they barely justified it in that Samus was injured during the last fight against Mother Brain. And
I don't remember, you know, being injured trying to escape from the fucking planet that was exploding!
Right. You're doing the meeting room.
This guy kind of looks like Shigeru Miyamoto.
Except, you know, not with the glasses.
Yeah.
Don't remember the glasses. Then again, I'm crazy.
He has, like, the same head shape and kind of the same hair. And
I knew it to be true, but still couldn't help looking at my palm for a sign.
So, wait, dude, describing... Oh, that's bad writing! You can't describe what's happening on screen with monologues.
You're gonna see a lot of that, unfortunately.
The finality of it struck me once again.
Oh, this voice actor's so bad, and I want this to be a good game.
The planet Zephys was annihilated, and all Metroids were exterminated.
We think.
Just announcing that in the huge room.
Almost dull, even.
Where there's presumed to be people there, but we don't actually see them.
They're not rendered.
No.
Oh shit, we forgot to render the people in the room!
So, welcome to, Star Wars.
I don't know how much time passed since then. Days went by in their quiet way, and people's recollections of Metroids in space.
You know, it's an interesting take having Samus kind of monologue. Galactic communities. Because she's clearly not talking out loud. She's a very, you know, silent person.
Codename
really
Baby's
the
Cry.
First, Codename Baby's Cry.
A common SOS with the urgency of a baby cry.
Why
so
with
bad.
This? Why with this
the
stupid fucking
comes from
theme?
The fact
seriously.
That the purpose of the signal is to draw attention. The signal was
I lost
coming
my train
from
of thought.
A remote part of space.
Oh yeah,
this game does that.
The course of my ship, as if this detour had already
and, you
been
know,
part of
wait,
my flight.
Has she always? She hasn't always had that flick of hair, has she?
Oh my god, the fucking is that supposed to be like a trackball mouse? Jesus Christ, I forgot about that.
Wasn't that in Metroid Prime, though?
No. I don't think she had that particular thing to control it in Prime.
Although trackball would be kind of interesting when you're in space.
Now, to go back a few seconds, at least, you know, this game actually doesn't take so long to get to a proper title card. Yeah. Look at you, Kingdom Hearts 2.
Here's half the game before the game starts.
Yeah, more like 3 hours.
Well, that just looks written. Oh, wow, that's actually pretty well made.
It's a trench run.
Her ship looks odd.
Yeah, I don't remember this design.
I don't know if it's the fact that they're trying to just perfectly emulate the Super Metroid ship, but I don't know. It doesn't feel sleek enough. And I know space, you don't need sleek, but
the stuff that you just totally like throw away logic-wise to try and justify some of this stuff
cool.
in video
I
games.
Mean, it looks like her mask. That's what the, her helmet. That's what the ships always do.
Mm-hmm.
Well, this is pretty standard.
Yes. Hopping out of the ship and beginning our exploration, except the first, like, minute of this exploration is in cutscene format, walking very slowly.
Yeah, what? Usually when you come out of there, that means the,
That means the game has fucking started.
Also, I notice our blaster inexplicably narrows at the end.
Which is fucking weird.
Oh,
there's something else here.
Oh, we got examinations, although
they're not nearly as good in this game.
Galactic Federation. Generic Empire Space.
Pretty much.
Well, this doesn't look too bad. This gameplay right here.
Hmm.
Are any of these 2D sections any bad? Any bad? Because I is good
bad.
English.
I is English good.
Oh. Bitch, we're on your side!
Look, that wasn't necessary. Come on.
Fancy meeting you here, princess.
So this guy's just going to be the chauvinistic dick
remember
throughout
me?
The,
No, I don't remember you.
There's only one person who calls me.
I actually remember the fucking point where the whole remember me thing was a meme.
Really?
Yes.
I don't.
Hey, and your buddy's here too.
It was a while ago.
Adam Malkovich.
Okay, so I'm gonna tell you a couple things about Adam that we would know if we had played games previous to when this was released. Adam Malkovich is referenced in Metroid Fusion as having a perfect military mind. Keep that in mind, okay? Just kind of store that one away and also keep track of what happens to every single other person other than Samus.
So, was prior to this game, was Samus ever hinted at being a soldier for the Galactic Federation at any point in her past?
In Metroid Fusion it was, but chronologically this takes place before Fusion.
Okay, so this is the first chronological hint
to answer his question
that she was working for the Galactic Federation when she was younger, and they beat it over your head.
Pretty much. Fucking fantastic, isn't it?
I'm fine with flashbacks, but we really haven't even gotten any gameplay yet.
Indeed.
We've traveled through two corridors and scanned a play.
Thing.
Logo.
Oh, we had a tutorial.
Ah, that's true.
Commander, we're all prepped.
I should just name this part fuck ton of cutscenes instead of let the flames begin. But whatever.
Explosion! That was a pretty well rendered explosion for the Wii.
Explosion fail! It did nothing!
No dice.
Because the Galactic Federation are fuck ups!
Wait.
This is gonna take a while.
The electrical system here is out, and we can't get the barrier wall.
Hold up.
Yes.
We tried using
the electrical system's out. How does their life support?
What we need
if they own the satellite, how did they not know the materials it was made out of before blasting the doors. If it was an interior door, how come there is no special way to open it?
Other than me shooting a missile at it.
Yeah.
I don't know. The weird safety protocols that you have when you're going in space and shit.
Let's go.
I want to question why these guys have traditional style guns, but then I realize arm blasters aren't really that efficient unless you have AR visor specifically tuned to targeting it.
Which actually they do.
Yeah. This is Halo style targeting.
Adam
pretty
hadn't
much
authorized it. But I decided to remain on site for the sake of the
So others. she talks about here how it wasn't authorized for her to stay there. Wait. Because she's never really had that problem with authorization before, and I'm aware that this game is notorious for its authorizations.
I would express my frustration, but I am not authorized to swear.
Ah. See, this looks like it could have been really fun if they stuck to just straight up 2D. This section right here.
Okay, we have these things, which you charge up your shot, and it activates something. You will see those a lot. That blue dot there, that is an item, but we can't get to it yet.
Ah. Typical Metroid fashion.
Indeed. I tell you how to get it, but I'm not authorized to do that.
This is going to become a running gag, isn't it?
Well, it becomes a running gag in this fucking game.
Oh, God. They've never addressed her
problems.
Oh,
I could fucking see that!
Oh, yeah, it's way too dark. They've never really had these problems with Samus not doing anything because she's authorized, even in chronologically earlier games. Hey, bathrooms!
Nah, these are locker rooms, actually.
Oh. What is this, Arkham Asylum?
I don't know.
They have to have you fill in the map, which is kind of fine. Can she not go into the men's locker room?
I guess not.
Huh.
Which is really strange, but whatever.
Because isn't this satellite supposed to be in...
Maybe it doesn't exist.
It's just a satellite full of women.
Something like that.
So have they addressed what these things are?
What?
These things that are attacking Samus?
They're just regular enemies. I wanted to bomb and get that energy tank, but I am not authorized to use bombs. I am not authorized to get items. I am not authorized to have fun in this game.
But wait, they said nothing about him authorizing anything Samus has to do.
But it did say, if you were paying attention, Samus has decided to not use bombs or missiles until Adam authorizes them for some fucking stupid reason.
I have this whole armory, but maybe I just won't use it until this general who I kind of hate tells me I should.
I don't think you should associate that with kind of hate.
I really don't know. That's the kind of relationship I get between Samus and Adam.
Right, more bullshit to come.